Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in for another video. We are still talking about concept testing as part of the product design and development course. So in this video, we are going to get into details about why we want to do concept testing and what are the benefits of doing concept testing. Please remember that at this stage, we have generated a lot of concepts for our product and we have selected one of two concepts. And now we want to test and see if those concepts that we have selected are the ones that we should go forward with and develop. So in general, why are we going to do concept testing? It's going to help us to make a go or no-go decision. So you have selected hopefully one or two concepts and you think those are the ones that you want to go forward with. Now it's the time to go and get some feedback from real customers that are going to buy your product and see if you go ahead or not. Also, you need to identify the market segment that you want to target precisely at this stage. And you want to make sure that what market to be in with this concept that you have selected. Also, if you, after the concept generation and the concept selection steps, you came up with two or three concepts to move forward with, which can happen and happen frequently, you need to find which one of these concepts to move forward with. And you need to get some feedback from real customers. Tell them those are the three concepts that we decided to move forward with which one of them is the best. So it will go to reduce our, choices. Also, you're going to confirm at this by doing concept testing that the concept that you selected is the right one to go forward with, because concept testing should help us in identifying the market size and also the percentage of people who might be willing to buy our product. This is very important to be identified at this stage. Also, it's helpful in benchmarking. So when we talk with people and we have now a clear concept that we want to move forward with, people will tell us what are the similar products that are available and how different ours from them. Also, you can solicit improvement ideas from people and from real customers at this moment. So it's not open to the general public, but now we are targeting a specific portion of people that will represent our market segment. And that will come down to something called forecasting demand. And we will talk more about it because this is a very important step. And are we ready to launch our product or not? So this is in general, what are the purposes that concept testing will serve us? It's going to take a long time to do the concept testing, a lot of thinking, but it's very, very important for our product development. Now, if you remember from the previous video, we said we have 7 steps in the concept testing process. And we're going to talk briefly about them and then we'll go into details. So step number one is that defining the purpose of the test. So before doing the testing, we need to identify what is the question the team wishes to answer with this test. So if I'm making this test, what is my question? And some examples of these questions like, do customers like the concept we have developed? Which of the several alternative concepts should be pursued? And also another example is approximately how many units are likely to be sold. So you need to identify what is the purpose of the testing. And this is very important. That's step one. Step two, you need to choose a survey population. And now we are getting into the details or the process of identifying our market, our target market. So you need to make sure that the population of potential customers surveyed reflects that of the target market for the product. And to do this, before we do it, let's say you're doing concept testing using survey. So you will create a survey, you will ask customers what do they think about our concept that we want to develop. So before starting the survey or the first portion of your survey, something should be something called screener questions, which means that there are questions to verify that the respondent fits the definition of our target market. And we'll talk more about this. And also you need to, at this step, you need to identify your sample size. How many people do you want to survey? This is very important. And it depends on the stage at which you are in the development process, and also it depends on what is the purpose of your testing. So there is an exhibit 9-3 in the textbook that can tell you what are the criteria to select a smaller sample size or a larger sample size. From an engineering point of view and from scientific point of view, there are some criteria of how to identify your sample size, and it all depends on your confidence intervals, and that this is related to statistics, and hopefully you're taking or took statistics class and you know what is the p-value, which is 0.005. That's you're confident that the decisions, they're different, and not because of chance, but because of the real differences between them. So, and this will help us identifying the sample size. We're not going to go into details, but this is something to look at, actually. So choosing survey population, we are going to do something at the beginning is the screening questions, and then we have to identify the sample size. And we'll talk about more about this in the coming videos. The third step is choose a survey format. Are you going to do face-to-face, phone interview, email, and internet? But be careful that you don't have to get something called sample bias. So if you're using an email, all your population might be categorized as technologically sophisticated. So be careful about that. This is very important. And we'll talk more about it. Then you need to communicate your concept. And when you communicate the concept, you can select between different modalities of how you want to communicate your concept to the respondents. So you can put sketches, you can create more realistic, let's say, cardboard, rendered, prototypes for people to see. And it depends on your market, on your segment, the market that you're targeting. And also, but here's the thing to keep in mind. If you are using, let's say, sketches, you need to use sketches for all your concepts that you are communicating. So if you are trying to get feedback about three concepts, you should select the same communication modality. So all of them should be sketches. You can't have two of them represent or communicated as sketches and one of them as cardboard. You have to be consistent in your communication. And the types of communication that you can use verbal description, you can use sketches, photos, you can use storyboards, you can use also videos, simulation, interactive multimedia, or physical appearance models or working prototypes. So it depends on at which stage you are in your process, and you will be asked to do something for your project, and I will send you in the weekly activity grid what is needed from each team. Okay, the fifth process, this fifth step, is measuring customer response, and you need to measure the response in such a way. So we need to see first, you need to communicate the product with them and then measure their response. And measuring the response, there's a lot of modalities. One of them is a selections. So you can ask them, and these five selections might be, I will definitely would buy, I would probably would buy, might or might not buy, probably would not buy, and definitely would not buy. This will give us a scale about how the customers are responding, and it will give us information about our forecast, how many people will buy our, definitely, let's say, buy our product, and we'll talk more about this. The sixth step is interpreting the results, and here we will study what we get from the feedback, and we can get report information about the sales potential and durabilities. And if you have two or more concepts, things might be simple, but if you have a lot of concepts and it's much more complicated and you were unable to identify a winner, you need to look into other alternatives of how to make the decision and how to get reasonable information from your data. And you will be asked to create a concept test survey that will help us do this, actually. The last step will be reflection on the results and the process. And here in this test, you need to see, did you answer your question that you started with, which is the core of your concept testing? And the most important, there are three important